Hey everybody, and welcome back to Angling Archaeology. And today we're going to be fishing some 70's soft plastics. We're over here at the lake lot, which is lower than I've ever seen it, so I'm not sure if that's going to make or break anything, but heck, we're here to find out. So stick around, we'll see if we can find some fish. Now let me give you an idea of exactly how low this is. First off, most of this is always submerged. And if you look out here, I don't know if you can see in that area over there, I actually threw in, oh, there's a couple of them. There's one over there as well too, somewhere. Okay, there you go, in that vicinity. There's two different fishing habitats I threw in the water that were both completely submerged. And now you can start seeing them kind of sticking out of the water now. So I don't know, this is pretty low, but hey, you know what, we're gonna give it a whirl. All right, so the first bait we're gonna throw today is the Tom Mann stingray grub. Now this one's been around forever. This was super popular back in the 70s, early 80s. I think it may have been one of the top selling soft plastic lures of the time. Tom Mann actually designed this bait to initially be for saltwater, but then obviously took on for bass fishing as well too. This particular one comes with a jig head, which is super heavy. I could probably also use this as a boat anchor for the SS Minnow up there, but hey, we're gonna try it. We're gonna see if it works. It was obviously popular for quite some time, so there's a reason for it. The little worms are kind of what you would expect, just little grubs, still popular today. Very versatile, bass fishing, crappie, I mean, whatever you want. I mean, this thing will pretty much catch it all. So let's throw it out there and see what happens. All right, here you go. So you can see how I got it set up here. It's basically just almost like a Ned rig right there. You let the tail do all the action and we'll go from there. Man, this thing is heavy. So I got a feeling this thing's gonna get caught up pretty much in anything that's underneath the water over there. But hey, we're gonna give it a try. In 1967, Tom Mann developed the jelly worm. It was likely soon after that he also developed the stingray grub. Now, the stingray grub was initially used for saltwater fishing, but then became popular amongst bass fishermen. By the time we get to 1972, the stingray grub is one of Tom Mann's top sellers, coming in 15 different colors, including 5 with a fire tail. The stingray was also a popular application for the Woolly Bully spinnerbait and grub spin, which was like the beetle spin. Okay, well that lead head that I had on before, that was way too heavy. That was getting caught up in everything. So I just went to a traditional Ned head. I believe this one's 1/10, might be 1/15. I don't know. Anyways, a lot smaller, so we'll see if this works.
Oh, dang, just had one.
Listen, been out here for about 20 minutes. Been a little bit of a grind, but you know, at least I know they're still working, you know, kinda. Had a fish on, it was tiny, but we're gonna get it back. All right, so we're back here at day 2, and we're gonna try this again, but this time, We're going to take out the SS Minnow, and I'll be damned if I didn't remember every single thing this time. Now, usually I forget, a boat motor, the seats, paddles, cooler, boat anchor, key to the lock. Now, before we jump in, I'm just going to go ahead and let you guys know what we're going to be fishing with today. Now, we're not going to give up our mission with the stingray grub. That thing is a fish catcher. I know it. It's been around forever. It's super effective. Great little bait. We just, we got to get outside this kind of, 10 by 20 area over here of fishing and really explore the whole lake. I think, we were just limiting ourselves. But, hey, this one, I'm not going until we... Well, listen, I have to leave at some point. The Chiefs are on later. But this one is, we're going to catch some fish on this today. I'm just going to tell you that right now. Next, Bass Buster Slinky Worm. This was pretty popular back in the early 70s. I think the first, advertisement I've seen on these is probably 1972. And at that time, they looked a little bit different. You can see this worm right here. It's almost got kind of a drop shot feel to it. Very kind of small, kind of thin design, whatever else. The earlier ones that I've seen look a lot more like they've kind of got the look of a jelly worm, but the kind of body of a Garcia hogtail. If you've ever seen any of those before, look that up. In fact, it's probably most like the Garcia. And it also had kind of this, fin type design tail on it that was pretty cool. So we're gonna fish this today. We're kind of downsizing. So I guess you can say this is a downsized 70s. Soft plastic video. The next one is Mr. Twister. Mr. Twister came out in 1973. It was the first initially designed in 72 with the curly tail, I believe. And then in 73, it kind of went into production. Correct me if I'm wrong. I probably am wrong. I need to fact check myself on that. But we've got a little kind of shad imitation. This one's probably not actually from the 70s per se, but Mr. Twister's been around forever and they were certainly super hot in the 70s. So we're going to fish it. And last but not least, this is not 70s, but super close. It's 40 years old. And this one is the Cajun Crawdad. This one came out in 1982. Very cool. It's just more or less just a little crawfish imitation, or crawdad, I guess, whatever. But there you go. Tom Mann's 1982. This is a really cool one. It reminds me a whole lot of the Z-Man crawfish or crawdad or whatever you want to call it. Very cool. We'll kind of do a little side-by-side comparison with this and the Z-Man. But a neat little bait. We're going to fish this. I think this is going to be super effective, especially around the rocks. Great little bait. And there you go. Well, let's get that boat on the water. Nice. See, there we go. You just had to get out of the 10 by 10 little area that I was fishing before, and right there, you got the bass. All right, so up next, we're gonna try the Cajun Crawdad right here. Let me show you the, here's the box from 1982, 40 years old. Let me show you a little side-by-side comparison. Very similar to the TRD craws. You can see almost, not totally identical, but very close. Oops, as I slips out of my hand there, you can see the comparison there. So let's give it a whirl. As you can see, I just rigged this up like you would, like a Ned rig. Just, the weight down here at the bottom, you got the appendages flopping up like that. It's gonna give it all the action. And let's give it a whirl. There we go, Cajun Craw. Okay, so up next we're gonna try the Slinky Worm right here. And normally I'd probably try to rig this, maybe wacky or drop shot or something like that, but I'm gonna be honest, I'm just too lazy today to retie something on. So we're gonna hook this up like the rest of them, just like a Ned, and we'll see what happens. Okay. Here you go. This is what it's gonna look like. Not bad. Yeah. There you go. There it is. Slinky worm strikes. Here we go. Dinky on a slinky. There it is. Okay, last but not least, we got the Mr. Twister. This little shad imitation. More of a swim bait, but I'm going to just put it on a net head and bring it in like I did the rest. Oh, man, that was, oh, he's back for more. Got him. Ooh, nicer one. Nicer as in like quarter pound. Anyways, here we go. Mr. Twister does it. It's freaking awesome. Oh yeah, there we go. Nice one. There you go. Mr. Twister strikes again. There we go. It's been like over 20 today, which tells me a few things. A, these 70 soft plastics still work. And B, these fish are hungry and really stunted. This one doesn't count. This is a bluegill, so we're not even gonna show you this one. But all the bass have been around a quarter pound, so, and this bluegill is peeing all over me. There it is. Oh yeah. It's a little better one. This is probably half pound. God, he was barely hooked. There you go. Problem is, you're not going to find too many fish in here over that size, so they probably need to be kind of harvested out a little bit, which maybe I need to work on that. Oh well. I didn't bring a cooler. That's one thing I forgot. Also, one of my batteries didn't work either. So, you know, it is what it is. And of course, the camera turns off as soon as I catch this absolute whopper. Here's a little better view of the habitats. You can see they're really sticking out of the water. There's another one over there. Well, I think we learned a few different things today. First and foremost, these soft plastic lures from the 1970s perform just as good today as they did 40, 50 years ago. We caught over 30 fish in an hour and a half. Now, keep in mind, they're all a quarter pound, which means this lake is severely stunted. That's for another episode. That's fine. We'll figure out a way to maybe relocate some of these fish. But these lures work out great. So I downsized it in this episode. We're going to have another upcoming episode where I do a little bit larger jelly worms, ringtail worms, stuff like that. So stick around for that episode. But that's going to do it for this one. So thanks for watching Angling Archaeology, where we unearth the good old days. We'll be right back.